The leather gleamed. Listen to this, a new one brought to you by Rodney's Publishing. All short stories can be found on my YouTube channel. Listen till the end, then click the link in my bio for more. Sunroof open, I took a deep breath. New car smell was intoxicating. After months of saving, the car was finally mine. Driving home from work, the world felt full of possibility. This car, this feeling, it was a fresh start. The engine hummed a sweet melody. I tapped the steering wheel, a grin spreading across my face. The open road stretched before me, an invitation to freedom. For the first time in a long time, I felt truly happy. As I turned onto my usual route, the familiar scenery whizzed by, trees blurred, houses became streaks of colour. I was pushing the speed limit, eager to get home and share my excitement with my family. "Good day!" I waved out to Mrs. Anderson, my son's schoolteacher. The thought of their faces, their joy, filled me with warmth. I eased my foot off the gas, a knot of unease forming in my stomach. The light turned yellow as I approached the intersection. My mind raced. Stop or go? Stupidly, I chose the latter. Pressing down on the gas, I ignored the voice in my head screaming at me to slow down. Adrenaline surged through my veins. The car lurched forward, engine roaring. For a moment, everything seemed to slow down. The world around me narrowed to a tunnel vision, focused solely on the green light ahead. As I sped through the intersection, a flash of movement caught my eye. A car, coming from the opposite direction, was approaching fast. I slammed on the brakes, but it was too late. The screeching of tires filled the air, a deafening symphony of metal and despair. Pain exploded in my chest, stealing my breath. My vision blurred as a wave of nausea washed over me. The smell of gasoline and burning rubber filled the air, choking me. I fumbled for my seatbelt, my hands shaking uncontrollably. Disoriented and terrified, I struggled to make sense of what had just happened. Through the haze of pain and shock, I saw the other car. It was mangled, its front end crumpled like a discarded piece of paper. Smoke billowed from beneath the hood, a grim testament to the violence of the collision. My heart pounded in my chest, a drumbeat of fear and guilt. Suddenly, the gravity of the situation hit me. I had caused this. My reckless actions had led to this horrific crash. Mustering all my strength, I unbuckled my seatbelt and stumbled out of the car. The world spun around me, a dizzying kaleidoscope of flashing lights and panicked voices. The courtroom was cold, sterile. The air hung heavy with anticipation, thick with the weight of judgment. I sat at the defendant's table, my hands clammy, my heart pounding against my ribs like a trapped bird. Across from me, the jury sat impassive, their faces unreadable. My lawyer, a seasoned professional with a reassuringly calm demeanor, had prepared me for this moment. He had gone over the evidence, the testimonies, the potential outcomes, but nothing could truly prepare me for the overwhelming feeling of guilt and shame that washed over me as I sat in that courtroom. The charges were read aloud, each one a hammer blow to my already fragile composure. Reckless driving, property damage, vehicular assault. My life, as I knew it, was hanging by a thread. And then, the moment I'd been dreading arrived. The prosecution called their first witness. The witness stepped into the courtroom, her face pale, her eyes filled with a mixture of pain and something else. Anger? Disappointment? I couldn't be sure. But it was the familiarity of her features that sent a shiver down my spine that made my stomach drop to the floor. It was Mrs. Anderson, my son's teacher. Her arm was in a sling, her face bruised. She walked with a limp, her usual warmth replaced by a stoicism that chilled me to the bone. Her gaze met mine for a fleeting moment, and in that instant I saw it all. The pain, the fear, the betrayal. The prosecutor guided her through her testimony, her words painting a vivid picture of the accident. She spoke of the impact, the searing pain, the fear that had gripped her as she realized what had happened. Her voice was steady, controlled, but beneath the surface I could sense her simmering rage. "He was driving so fast," she said, her voice trembling slightly. Her words were like daggers piercing through my heart. The trial dragged on. Each day was an agonizing reminder of my mistake. The evidence was damning, the testimony heartbreaking. My lawyer, though skilled, was fighting an uphill battle. The guilt was a suffocating weight, crushing me beneath its immense pressure. News of the accident had spread through our small town like wildfire. Whispers followed me everywhere I went. The judgment in people's eyes was inescapable. My once friendly neighbors now avoided my gaze. The accident had not only shattered bones and metal, but it had also fractured my reputation, my relationships, my sense of self. My wife, bless her heart, stood by me, but I saw the strain in her eyes, the worry etched on her face. The accident had taken its toll on her too. The verdict came after what felt like an eternity. Guilty. The word hung in the air, a resounding confirmation of my recklessness, my failure. The sentence was lighter than it could have been, a testament to my lawyer's skill and the judge's leniency. But it was still a heavy burden to bear. There was a fine, of course, and community service, but the real punishment was the knowledge that I had hurt Mrs. Anderson. No, she wasn't just my son's school teacher, she was an acquaintance that I had adored, the innocuously betrayed, the trust of my family and my community. The scars of that day, both physical and emotional, ran deep. Mrs. Anderson recovered, but her injuries left her with a limp, a constant reminder of the crash. The guilt of knowing that I was responsible for her pain was a heavy weight to bear. I visited her after the trial, hoping to apologize. She accepted my apology with a quiet grace that belied the pain I knew I had caused her. Life moved on, as it always does, but it was a different kind of life, one forever marked by the accident. The reckless abandon I had once felt behind the wheel was replaced by a cautious awareness, a profound respect for the fragility of life. The new car smell faded, replaced by the lingering scent of guilt and regret. The open road, once a symbol of freedom, now felt fraught with danger, a constant reminder of the potential consequences of my actions. I threw myself into my community service, hoping to make amends for the harm I had caused. I volunteered at a local soup kitchen, helped clean up parks, visited nursing homes. Each act of service, though small, was a step towards redemption. I became an advocate for safe driving, sharing my story at schools and community events. If my experience could prevent even one person from making the same mistakes I had, then perhaps some good could come from all this pain. Time, they say, heals all wounds. And while the scars of that fateful day may never fully fade, I have learned to live with them. The guilt, the shame, the regret, they are all a part of me now, woven into the fabric of my being. I have learned the hard way that actions have consequences, that even a momentary lapse in judgment can have life-altering repercussions. I have learned the importance of responsibility, accountability, and forgiveness. Most importantly, I have learned to appreciate the preciousness of life, the fragility of human connection, the importance of cherishing every moment. The accident may have shattered my life, but it also forced me to confront my demons, to rebuild myself from the ground up. And so, I drive on, forever changed by the experience. The road ahead may be long and the scars may never fully fade, but I face the future with a newfound sense of purpose, a determination to honor the lessons I've learned. Thank you for your time. If you like this story view, my playlist, Rodney's Film Club, you can find the book's print on demand, Brain Boxing, Crime Artist, Crime Fame, Fortune and Glory, and my latest published November 11, 2023, Leave Room for Human Errors. That one has 13 short stories. Until the next time, be on the lookout for The Looking Glass, another selection of shorts I'll publish soon. You'll never find stories like these anywhere, so don't be shy. Subscribe, share with a friend. Thank you.